What's up, everybody, and welcome to the vlog. It's where is it? Hold on a second. Okay, so I'm leaving work, and right before I go to pull out of the plant, I found this on the road. Now, most of y'all know me for finding things on the road, but this is a first for me. I don't know whose it is. I didn't want to turn around, go to my job, and go put this in the lost and found, or go, hey, whose phone is this? I know there's ways of tracking a phone or whatever. I planned on turning it on, so it's either got a dead battery or there's like some secret way of turning this thing on, because I cannot figure out a way to turn this thing on. How in the hell you turn this thing on?
Hey.
I thought that was a second lens. Maybe it's a piece of trim. Ah! It worked! I looked everywhere on this thing. There's no bump, like... Well, that's good. We turned it on. I guess we'll worry about finding the people later. Should I turn... Can you track a phone when it's off? Because I kind of don't want them to know where I live. You know, them show up at the house thinking I stole their phone and everything. Maybe we should just turn this thing off. So I went out on a little break to try to cool off, and I passed by this creek. Look at these minnows. There's a whole pool of them. Come on, camera. There's at least 1,000 right there. I need to get my cast net and come over here. Yeah, it feels nice. Beautiful. Now we're at my creek, and there's a bunch of minnows, but not as... There's only a couple of them here. We got a couple of them here. But not as big, it's not as many as the other creek. Man, who did that? Golly. I swear, I spend more time cleaning up trash than I do anything else. I wonder if my creek goes all the way up to that other creek, or connects to it somehow. I almost kind of want to throw the cast net in and see what I can get. I think that's what I'm going to do. Let's see what we can get with the cast net. Let's go back to the house and go get it real quick. Well, I got my cast net. I went to go grab my tripod, but I can't find my tripod. So I'm going to have to improvise on that. But this is what I've been working on today. I need to get the hogs into this pasture. So here in the next couple days, we'll be knocking down what I sprayed over there and getting them back into this pasture, and then fixing some of the fence around here. Then I will be taking this pasture right here, and I'll probably add a T-post, maybe not, it depends on how well. I got insulators, and I got, I think it's a poly rope or poly wire rope. It's a visible wire for the horses, and I'll be running it along here, the same pasture, and I'll get the horses over here. And then I need to train the boar to an electric fence as well. And so I'm making them a little enclosure right here. And then on the inside of the enclosure, I'm gonna be running these little rebar right here. And I'm gonna run a little thing of wire, just about that height, maybe a little bit lower since he's still young. Run it on the inside of the fence, and it'll teach him. I'll probably go ahead about 8 to 10 inches off this, and hopefully it gives him enough area to run. This will be his first time outside when we bring him out here, so I wanted enough area for him to run without running into the fence. Hopefully. If he runs into the fence, he's pretty strong. He could possibly knock it down, bend it, realize that there's a little flex right here and try to push hard enough under there. I mean, hogs are really smart, and they definitely use their snouts and their heads to their advantage. Well, now that I got y'all caught up with that, let's go down to the creek. I'm thinking if I could, I'm gonna have I'm going to have to look on my map. I know a lot of land around here that touches water is private property. But we're going to go down to my creek and throw the net and see if we could get something. I don't know. I kind of really want to go to the other creek. Let's go to the other creek and see if we could get something over there. So is this going to be an excuse to play in the pool every day? I'm going to go clean the pool. Well, it looks a lot better than it normally does, so whatever you want to do. Whatever floats your boat, you go ahead and clean that pool every day. All right, I'm going to go down to the creek.
Okay. I'll be safe.
I'll be safe or you'll be safe? I know you'll be safe.
I'll be safe.
I mean, you're right here. All right, let's go down to the creek. Hang on there. I know one thing. I'm under the bridge right now at the other creek I wanted to go to, and there's a lot of writing on these walls. I'm gonna have to probably blur out or black out or something. Actually, I'm just gonna go ahead and see y'all on the creek away from this bridge. Oh man, what a way to make a man blush. I can tell you that much right now. Okay, looks a little bit better under here. All right, so I saw that big school. That's probably them right there. See, when I first initially came over, they were over, oh, they are still over there. They're still over there. There's a whole bunch of them right there. I'm gonna see if I could get them. I have no tripod, guys, and I was gonna use my little clamp thing to clamp to a branch, but there's no branches nearby to get the shot, so I'm gonna balance y'all, I guess, on this bucket or something. I don't know, I'll figure something out. And right there, I ran out of battery on my camera. Yeah. It was a fresh battery, too. As soon as I left the house, I was like, well, let me change the battery out. Let me grab this. Let me grab that. Went down there. And then I was sitting there. I sat there, talked, pulling out the fish, showing you guys the fish. But apparently, I wasn't doing anything but talking to a bucket with the turned off camera. So, yeah. I did catch a couple fish. I caught way more than a couple fish, but I threw them all back out, and I figured from now on, if I need live bait or whatever, I could go down to over there or into my creek and everything, use that cast net. I want to go on the river too, see if I could get some shad or whatever using it, get more practice on the boat. Today I wasn't really fully there. I had cut my arm pretty bad at work. And so, yeah, I was trying not to open up my cut again. I have gotten a little bit better on the cast net, and I promise, guys, you will see me soon throw the cast net without any camera problems. I swear, I'm gonna have 15 different angles just in case. No, I'm not gonna do that. I don't even have that many cameras. But I will make sure the wife is there with her phone just in case my camera decides to crap out again. All right, so update on the phone. Well, we went ahead, tried to find the person's social media page. Of course, they had a Facebook. But unfortunately, they were locked out, or logged out. So we're kind of scratching our heads, and Chelsea said a notification came up on the person's phone, and it was an email, and it said, hey, and it had a person's name. So we're assuming that maybe that person is the person's name, or that maybe that person's name is the person of the owner of the phone. Wait. On the hell, whatever. I'm sure y'all understand me. We have like three different companies that use the access road where we go into our gate to go to work. And one of those companies, this person could be working for. So I'm going to go to my company I work for, and I'm going to go to another company that I work right next to. I'm going to see if in their system they got anybody with the name that popped up on the email. And hopefully one of them says yes, because I honestly don't know what to do from here with the lost phone. So I don't know if I should end the vlog here and let it roll into tomorrow, so I can let you know what that's what I'm gonna do. All right, guys, it is the next day. Unfortunately, I was not able to get a hold of the owner of the phone, so I'm pretty much just gonna keep it and sell it on eBay and make a profit off of it, you know, extra feed money for the farm. I'm kidding, guys. I didn't know. No, I am not that kind of person. No, actually, what I did was I got a hold of a supervisor of a company that we work beside, and they were able to find a name of a notification that came up on an email, and we found the owner of the phone, but I seriously didn't get a hold of the owner. I gave that phone to the supervisor so that the next time he came in on his shift, he was able to get his phone back, so that is awesome. He's very lucky, because I had to stop the truck. The reason why I couldn't get that thing on camera of me finding a phone on the road or in the middle of the road is because there was traffic coming and there was a car going, hey, what are you doing? I'm like, wait. You know, that guy would have been a couple hundred dollars short, you know, if somebody would have ran over it. You know, it's just. Well, anyways, that was my good deed for yesterday. But yeah, guys, I'm glad I was able to, I guess save somebody's phone for them. It's not really a big speech that I'd make for it, but every time I drive, I'm always looking for something good on the side of the road. There's a lot of people losing things, a lot of people that dump stuff off that somebody else can use, and I'm one of those somebody else's that can use stuff that they lose or drop. But a cell phone, a wallet or something, that's something that I would actually find the owner for and everything. So that's not something I would keep for myself. But guys, that's all I have for today. Thank you for watching the vlog. I will see y'all tomorrow.